Welcome to Rajendra Tandon videos. We continue with another few verses from Vidur Niti. Vidur was the Prime Minister of Hastinapur. He was advisor to the King Dhritarashtra, who was physically blind. Dhritarashtra was also mentally blind and impervious to the faults of his ambitious son Duryodhana. According to Krishna, Vidur was considered as Dharmaraj, the Lord of Truth. Krishna respected Vidur for his devotion to people's welfare and his proficiency in every sphere of knowledge. When Krishna visited Hastinapur as a peace emissary of the Pandavas, he shunned Duryodhana's offer to stay in the royal palace, preferring instead the home of Vidur. On account of him being the only neutral man in the Kaurava court, during Krishna's visit, Vidur repeatedly advised everyone in the court to pay heed to the messenger. Nobody listened to him. Rather, Duryodhana reprimanded him. In the verses which I am taking up today, there is a discussion between Dhritarashtra and Vidur. Dhritarashtra said, "My worries keep me awake. Please advise how I should proceed next. You alone among us are dexterous in the knowledge of dharma and artha. O generous Vidur, let me know your honest views after careful consideration. What would be the most suitable way out for Yudhishthira as well as the Kauravas?" "Wise man, I always fear the worst. All around I see nothing but the signs of doom. With a disturbed mind I ask you, what are the demands of Ajatashatru Yudhishthira? Please tell me the truth." Vidur replied, "Shubham va yadi va papam dvesha va yadi va priyam apristas tasya tad bruyat yas necha parabhavam." As a matter of principle, an advice of a well-wisher must ever be honest, even if it hurts and even if it unasked for. Mithyopatyani karmani siddheyu yani bharata anupaya prayuktani masma teshu manakritha. O Bharata, one should not indulge in deceitful acts in order to succeed in vicious designs. Tathaiva yoga vihitam yattu karmam na siddhyati upayuktam medhavi na tatra galpeyanam. Likewise, it is not wise to be disheartened if you do not succeed, even after putting in a careful and honest effort. One must be clear about one's objectives before initiating an activity. What an advice! Think deep before taking a step forward. One must not hurry thoughtlessly. Anubandham cha samprekshya vipakam chaiva karmanam utth thanam atmanas chaiva dhira kurvit va na va. A thoughtful person must think of the purpose, the consequences of an activity and the accruing benefit, if any, before taking up a project. Vidur offers advice to Dhritarashtra without fear. Na rajyam praptyam ityev vartitavyam samapratam shriyam he vinayo hanti jara rupam ivottamam. Having attained a kingdom, the king must not become overconfident and treat others unfairly. And that is what you are doing, my brother. Arrogance and an unbending temperament destroy wealth, as old age shatters good looks. What a simile. Arrogance and unbending temperament destroy wealth as old age shatters good looks. A greedy fish, Vidur says, swallows the steel bait covered with tempting victuals. It does not for a moment think of the consequences. Anyone who desires to make a headway ought to adopt means that will ensure his success. A man should eat what is edible, what can be digested, and what will nourish his body. This is an advice for everybody, not only for Dhritarashtra. Vidur continues, Yatha madhu samadatte rakshana pushpani shad shatpadah tadva arthan manushebhya adyadad vi hinsaya. Like the black bee which sucks the sap of a flower while protecting it. What a minute observation. The bee protects the flower yet sucks the nectar to make honey. A king gathers taxes painlessly from his subjects. A gardener plucks flowers but does not pull out the roots of the plant. Similarly, a king gathers taxes in order to provide protection to the public. He does not uproot them like the person making charcoal out of it. Another great simile. Carefully consider an action, O king, to its end. Will it be beneficial or harmful? A decision to perform a task should be based on such considerations. I stop here today. I shall take up some more verses in the next video. Every word Vidur spoke was well thought out. It was an advice to the blind, selfish king. But there is a lot of advice for common man like you and me. Thank you for visiting the site. Thank you for listening to me.